Well, this is a lady with retinal macroaneurysm at the lower temporal arcade, and the subretinal bleeding engages the macula. So I perform an intravitreal RTPA injection with gas, and positioning with face down. After 2 months, the patient presented with a pressure of 45 millimeter mercury. You can see that there is hyphema present with old and fresh blood. So starting now with an irrigation aspiration to remove the blood. Then the next step is a phaco emulsification. Of course, you need a vision blue because there is no red reflex. Then implantation of an one-piece IOL. And now comes an interesting step. I'm trying to do an anterior vitrectomy, but I cannot see the vitreous cutter behind the lens capsule. It is completely, I'm even putting on now the red reflex, but the cutter is not visible. So this is very unusual, even in a very dense vitreous hemorrhage. So what I'm doing now, I'm holding the cutter behind the lens capsule and doing a sort of a blind anterior vitrectomy. Now a bit further, you can see a bit better now, but still it's a very bad view. So I'm now injecting BSS to improve the view. But you can still see that the vitreous cutter is very difficult to visualize. So the question is, where is the blood? Is the blood maybe inside the anterior chamber, inside the lens capsule? So I decide to repeat irrigation aspiration and remove blood from inside the lens capsule. But I cannot find blood here. But let's see if there is some improvement. You see, there is still a staining there. So it must be staining on the posterior part of the lens capsule due to the severe hemorrhage. So I'm opening now the posterior lens capsule, and now the view, the vitreous cutter, is good. So there was a strong staining with blood on the posterior side of the lens capsule. In fact, also on the iris. Now we can see the vitreous with a very dense hemorrhage. It looks like Dracula's living room. This is a status 2 months after injection with RTPA and gas. It's important to check the infusion cannula, but you can see that the infusion cannula is located inside the vitreous cavity. So I continue to remove this very densely hemorrhage inside the vitreous cavity, staining the complete vitreous, I assume that the hemorrhage is so severe in this case because there was a strong bleeding from an artery, retinal mechaneurism, resulting in this very strong bleeding into the eye, staining the posterior capsule, staining the iris, and causing the severe IOP increase by occluding the trabecular meshworks with the red blood cells. So I think you can see now a little bit the mechaneurism. So the injection was successful. There's no more blood at the macula. I leave the vitreous base of this hemorrhage. Look now, there is a lot of pigmentation on the retina secondary to this hemorrhage. Even here, look at the pigmentation of the retina secondary to this hemorrhage. You see it even better now here. I leave a lot of the vitreous base in order not to have a retinal break. Fluid air exchange and removal of the troca cannulas.